Okay, so we're on this new job this morning. It's another footer job.
Let's get unloaded and get started.
Where you going?
What are you doing, dogs?
Fixing this, just put a marker, a perimeter around the house, just a guesstimate of where we think the house is going to sit, so we know where to start laying out our positive drainage and things from. And what we did right there is, you got to have 10 foot of positive drainage. This dot here, that line over there, and that line over there is 10 foot from that pole. On each side, and that's how much positive drainage you have to have around your house. You have to have 10 foot of a slope around your house so the water can drain off.
I'm trying to get him in touch with my first cousin on the queue.
One more question I got on my mind. Okay. I know, I reckon you're going to dig around before I do full concrete to lay my block on. Is that right?
Yes.
Okay, one question is, there any way that you can fix a ditch where I can go under that?
Okay.
We might drop the business card right there. Somebody's dropped a business card, Malachi.
What?
Business card.
No, that's probably that Stephen's guy. I beat him.
Okay. I'm about to go back to that dot I drawn.
Heard a little bit?
Hang on to it.
All right, do you own that way, Arbel, so I don't have to worry about that? Because I'm going to have to, you know, fix that. Yeah,
is there any property lines in here anywhere?
Yeah, the property line. See that old dead tree right there?
Yeah.
That old dead scrubby looking thing right there, that old bush looking thing?
Right
yeah.
There?
Yeah. Because there, that's property line.
Because we got to stay 10 from it from the house, so we're fine.
Yep.
Even if you own both sides, they make you do that.
Yep, that's fine. Yeah, we do.
That's positive drainage.
It probably ain't far from it.
We gotta have positive drainage to there anyway, so. The dots of it all. That dot there, that dot he's on, that dot up yonder, and this dot over here behind the excavator. But now the house.
Yeah, the house would be here.
It'd be inside there, yeah.
Yeah,
that'd
be probably. Fine.
We're gonna get a square line. I'm gonna show you more at lower corner.
Yeah, I see it. I was trying to measure it, and I tell you, I had a hair. I'm trying to get it square.
I look
at it one way and look cockeyed.
I'm gonna get you, and I'm gonna anticipate where you're going to your house is gonna be if you start the corner, this corner here.
Thank you.
camera died, but we're back up and running. been a couple days now, and we're back on the job. Finally got us a sunny day, and first thing we're gonna do is go ahead and get this tarp took up and see if this works or not on keeping this thing dry. Teeth a bit nipply this morning, ain't it, buddy?
Huh? I'll get this side. I'm done halfway done. Go get the ones up outside. Lay them on the back.
Okay, so as you can see, this that tarp we had over it really didn't do any good. I don't know if you can see or not, but it's still really muddy. Okay, so I mean, you compare this to what's over here, and this was the only part that wasn't covered with a tarp. So you can actually see the line right here that was covered with a tarp. It goes right up through there. And it's actually a lot muddier than what isn't. This over here is actually like almost like sand. You know, so I don't think we'll be doing that anymore. But at least now we know. It's a trial run anyway.
I don't know if you can look and see or not with your glasses, but there's literally a line of where the
tarp
was.
Yeah, I can see that.
And it's sand here.
And soaking wet over there.
And mud over there where the tarp was. Yeah. I mean, what sense does that make?
Huh? It didn't have no way to dry, just like I told you. It was wet when we put it there, right? You remember how it was muddy?
Yeah.
It didn't do nothing to sit there and soak.
Well, it froze up this morning.
Buddy?
You see the way out there?
See,
look,
everywhere where the
top
was wet.
Yep.
And everywhere where it wasn't,
was
dry.
Yep.
I started to
take that off
yesterday.
Let the
wind dried her out yesterday, but
I started to take that off yesterday. I thought, well, better not. We just said, make a mess. I started to throw it off and let the wind dry it off.
But that wind will work wonders on
stuff. I know.
It'll dry it out faster than you think it will. I'll do it like that.
Yeah. Yeah, I started taking off yesterday. I told my wife, I'm going to take that off, but I said, I better not fool with it. So, I did.
Well, listen, Cameron, let's get this corner right here staked off. We can get this stuff to get out of our turn. So, if you use plastic, you take it off when the sun is shining. Unless you want the ground to stay moist.
So, what we're doing right now is we're going to lay off our footers, as always. We're going to get the perimeter of the house first.
What happened to that other camp?
Mark the spots where our footers are going to be.
Easy.
Okay, so I guess I'll try to explain this one more in depth. What's going on here is, this is the, from this stake here over, that is our, over to this stake. Straight across, that's our, that's this side of the house. That's where the size of the house is gonna sit. Okay, and every one of these white marks you see, down the line, there's gonna be a perimeter, there's gonna be a footing on there somewhere down this line. So, on all of these lines, and there's gonna be multiple of them. So, you know, you have your measurements on this side, and you have the same ones over there. And what we're gonna do here in a minute, when they get those drawn out, is we're gonna lay our tape across every side, you know, from the first one on this side to the first one on that side. And what we're gonna do is walk across it. We have measurements laid out to where the footers need to be for this home. And we're gonna mark them all the way down on every notch, dig them, and pour. I think that right.
All right. That's right, folks. We got a measure from up there. So let's just use here. Just take this with you. Just use this tape.
Show this camera your phone.
Camera.
So he's reading off the layout.
Get us up. Get that other tank, we'll pull that up and I'm on
two. Okay, so now we got these two tapes laid across our first marks here, down, and across our second mark here. And so what he's doing down there is he's marking where footers need to be dug all the way down. And so we'll do that process three more times, and then we'll mark our perimeter. Thank you. Okay, so we've got all of our footers dug, so about to put the 2-foot bucket on and lay off our perimeter and dig it. Thank you.
But just try it and see. I don't know.
Thank you.
We've got it all in and on grade, but we don't have it. We don't have all of it troweled in, so we gotta finish that up. But when the concrete got here, we got really busy, and fooling with a camera wasn't really an option because, you know, it's sunny out today and this stuff will dry if you don't work it in fast. So this is what we got left to do. This is the finished product. Probably missed a lot of the smoothing out and the concrete getting poured. But yeah, it's just such a rush when that stuff gets here, you gotta go. So we done the best at filming we could. We may be returning on this job to do a driveway. On that note, it's time to get loaded up and get out of here.